air moves through two primary forces. The first is the weaker of the two, thermal effect, thermal buoyancy. Warm air will naturally rise and exit out of a vent. Then there's wind. Wind is a much greater mover of air. When wind hits a house, it creates high pressure in yellow, low pressure in purple. High pressure can actually push air back into the exhaust vent. We don't want that. Low pressure, purple, can pull air out of the vent, enhancing the vent's performance. We want purple whenever we can get it. I'm going to show you right now how we can get purple frequently. Here's a ridge vent using no wind, just thermal buoyancy. Notice the warm air, the red arrows rise and exit through both sides of the vent. Fantastic. Now let's bring in some Windy City area wind and watch what happens to these arrows. Please remember, high pressure yellow, low pressure purple. Here comes that Chicago wind. Now when the wind blows, that yellow arrow that you see is incoming wind effect through the windward side of the ridge vent. Bad news. With that wind is whatever Mother Nature's carrying that very moment. Rain, snow, debris. This is an exhaust vent, but because of wind effect, part of it ingests on the windward side. But now, if we put a little wing on that vent, if we put a little lip on that vent, we call it, by the way, an external wind baffle, and you bring back that wind, now look what happens. The wind strikes the wing and deflects up and over, creating a pocket of purple, low pressure, above the windward and above the leeward side of the vent. Goodbye, incoming yellow arrows. Only red arrows exiting the vent. And that's what we want, folks, even when the wind blows.